Hello everyone, I'm Sean. This is my friend Rob. You're watching Salt, my YouTube channel all about sports and interesting topics. And today the topic is going to be kind of sporty because Rob is going to be scuba diving and I'm going to be snorkeling.
Got my camera ready.
Cameras are ready. And it's also going to be kind of cultural because we're visiting an underwater archaeological site. So where the fuck are we?
We're in Baia, so the underwater city that sunk because of some seismic vibrations about 500 years ago or more?
No, more than that, like more than 1,500. So we're in Baia, not Baia in Brazil, unfortunately, but Baia in Naples. And so I'm going to post the link in the description of a video to a previous video of the archaeological park of Baia, where I visited the park on land, which is really, really nice and worth seeing. And now we're going to kind of complete that because we're going to go underwater. So it's typical that people like to make it extra hard. So rather than visiting the park above the water, which would make perfect sense
and cost like scuba diving,
cost €2 to visit and it's wonderful, we're going to be scuba diving to see a fraction of what we could see above the land,
but underwater.
So that's going to be very exciting. The Bradisism phenomena that Rob was talking about is due to a massive magma which is under us. And it's in Italian it's called caldera, so it's like a massive lava reservoir. It's 3 kilometers underground. It has given life to numerous volcanoes in the Flegrian Fields, and also it has risen or lowered the level of land. So in the case of Baia, it has lowered it, it's made it sunken, and that's why there are Roman remains underwater. Navigation is going to be non-existent, literally, because we're just a few hundred meters from the coast. So far, we have managed to see a first mosaic. Then we went to see a piece of a column marking the entrance of one of the Roman villas. And now we just saw the marble thresholds of the shops following the borders of the villa. And the last thing we're going to see is another mosaic, but this time it's quite unique because it's going to be a mosaic of gladiators. Thank you. So what was the part you liked most, Rob?
Uncovering the mud and discovering the mosaic is absolutely magical.
Sorry?
If you feel like an underwater archaeologist.
So I agree with what Roberto just said. That was the most fun part. This kind of magic that you go underwater and there's absolutely nothing, and then you move the sand aside and slowly the mosaic comes to life. That is so cool. And the reason why they do it is because this is the best way of preserving the mosaic, is just keeping it covered with sand, and at the end of a tour then they cover it over again. So you would never know it's actually there unless you knew the exact spot. So it's a bit like treasure hunting in a way as well. The difficulty of snorkeling was to find the exact amount of weight I needed, because I'm wearing a double wetsuit, so it's very buoyant. And first they only had 4 kilos on, and it wasn't enough to get me going down. And then I had like 7, I want to say, or maybe 6, and it was actually too much. And the opposite happened when I ran out of air, I couldn't go up again. Hey guys, don't forget, the name of the channel is
Salt, not Salty.
But so, just salt, I'm not salty, I'm not bitter. We're sweet as butter, Italian butter, that is.
Don't forget to subscribe.
If you like the video, please subscribe.
Subscribe to
the
Salt
channel. And the moon and the stars were the gifts you gave.